going to make the seed stitch, we're going to make just enough stitches so that I can show you how to do this. So we're going to cast on only 11 because it has to be an odd number. And the reason is that you knit and purl, knit and purl, knit and purl. Start with a knit on every row, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 11. Because it needs to be an odd number. And so we're going to knit and purl. Knit and purl. Knit and purl. And we do that the whole row. And we'll be there very soon because we only have 11. So you started with a knit and you're going to end with a knit because we have an odd number. So you start with a knit, you end with a knit. You turn, you start with a knit, and you end with a knit. The same on every row. And that's why we need an odd number so that this can be accomplished. And of course you can see that the stitch is like ribbing, knit one, purl one, knit one, purl one, but since you're alternating the stitch, it's going to show differently. And it looks like this, and it's called seed stitch. And it looks like this on this side and the same on the other side. So this is very nice for scarves or anything that you wish to have the two sides the same. So this is what it is. So Anna's idea was to make a sleeve for your coffee cup.
Pinterest inspired.
Yes, and this it has this thing that goes around. I took this as measurement, and I know for sure that 20 stitches give me 5 inches. So in order to have this thing around, which is 9 inches at the bottom, 10 inches at the top, so now I know that I need to cast on 36 stitches, and that's what I did. And then I did the height of this. And so now I'm going to sew it together.
What size needles and yarn was
it? It was a size 8 needles and a size 4 worsted yarn. And this is called, this one in particular is called I Love This Yarn. That's what it's called. And they have it at the Hobby Lobby because it's their brand.
What kind of stitch do you knit it with?
This, we're going to show you how to do this because it's called seed stitch.
And knit, purl, knit, purl, knit, purl, purl.
Yes, but you alternate it. Mm-hmm. So it is like ribbing, but it looks like this. And it's nice because it's very cozy. So there, we have a video on how to sew your edges together. And that's what I'm doing right now. So you can do this, which is alternative number one. And we're going to show you another one, which is alternative number two. One with a button and this one without. So what if we sew this all the way up, and this will be your alternative number one because you can just slide it in. So there we go. See how pretty that looks?
You can make that with any stitch.
Yes, you can do it. You can make it, you can make cables. Mm-hmm. So that would be very nice. But look how cute that looks Of course, we have another alternative is if we have a video with this, and this is the Tunisian stitch. And what if we do the size of it? Please look it up. It's the Tunisian stitch, and we show you how to embroider. And of course, you do your numbers to go around. But doesn't that look cute?
Mm-hmm.
So, of course, you know, this is going to be flat against it, but that's a good idea.
Yeah, you can embroider names, you can embroider different shapes, yes, as long as you do your little square design first on paper.
Yes. Well, it's the gage. You have to do your gage. So, I'm going to take the seam off, and I'll see you in a little bit. So, we put a button there, and we sewed it with the same yarn. And I passed the tail of the yarn from here to almost in the middle. And so let's make a loop for it to go around the button with your crochet hook. And so let's see, because it has to go around and it has to be able to go through. So that will go through. Okay, so that's all we need. And we sew this together with the other side, which will be more or less there. Make a knot there. So now let's weave the tail in. We cut that. So this is very nice because now you have a cozy that has a button. Isn't that cute?
That is cute.
So let's put this on your cup, and this is the way it's going to look. Have a cozy with a button.
They sell these mugs at different places. I mean, the classic ones are the Starbucks ones, but I've seen them at other grocery stores like Walmart, I think, even.
I didn't see
certain Walmarts, not all of them, but a lot of your grocery stores will have them in the coffee aisle. So look for them there. They're
isn't
ceramic.
Cute?
Yeah, you can also actually paint or the mug with paint or with Sharpies. So in case you're interested in that, you can also personalize it like that with your knitted sleeve also.
So isn't that cute?
It's super cute.
Yeah. And there you go.